The college football experience, Vanderbilt Commodores 2022 season preview episode on the Sports Gambling Podcast Networks presented by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get a $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/winbet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today. We're also brought to you by us. Yes, the college football experience. Get ready for college football season by checking out all 131 college football team previews. Just go to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/CFB. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/CFB.
This is Jim Mora, and you're listening to SGPN. Let it ride.
Yes, yes, yes. Woo-hee! Welcome. Welcome to the college football experience. Vanderbilt Commodores 2022 season preview episode. My name is Colby Swinging Dantabase Dan, aka Pick Dundee. That's not a pick. This is a pick.
He was raised in the land down under, where a man thinks on his feet, speaks with his fists, and lives by his wits.
When Dundee happened, he was a superstar.
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
Oh, yes! It is great talking Commodore football. Look, look, Clark Lee, he's working on a project here, but he's got good things going. This program's had some history. I've been watching this Commodore team since the days of Rod Dalhauer. Look, Franklin got it up. Derek Mason had some good years. This team, hey, look, it's a little bit, it's like Stanford, a little bit tougher to win, but it can happen. You can win games here in Nashville. And I'm excited about Clark Lee and what's going on. Maybe
it's easy to see a tide turn.
Maybe a little bit of that tide turning going on there in Nashville. Sign me up for this. And look, I mean, hopefully you're watching this on YouTube. Remember, subscribe. College Football Experience is now on YouTube, youtube.com/thecollegeexperience. And if not, subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts at. Also subscribe to the College Basketball Experience. Jerry Stackhouse, it's a big year for him in Nashville as the head coach of the Commodores, and we will have them previewed shortly. So subscribe over there as well. And remember, me and Noah Bienick host the College Baseball Experience. Yes, Vanderbilt fans, you're like a blue blood in college baseball. You don't need me to tell you that. So subscribe to all of those, and you'll enjoy all of those and the Sports Gambling Podcast as well. But here we're talking Vanderbilt Commodore football, and man, I mean, it was a tough season a year ago. It was a very tough season, but it was expected. It was expected because Clark Lee's coming in year one. The cupboard was a bit bare, and yeah, I mean, growing pains. They got housed by East Tennessee State, 23-3, a 20-point loss to the Buccaneers. Yeah, they ended up being an FCS playoff team, so yes, yeah, still a bad loss, but kind of justifies itself a tiny bit. Then they got a win, and this game was hilarious to me because a classic. I thought not to come at Clark Lee, but I thought Steve Adazio just completely botched this game. But Vanderbilt got a road win in Fort Collins. Against Colorado State by 3. Then they had a loss to Stanford, and then it kind of got ugly. 62-0 loss to the Georgia Bulldogs, but hey, they won the national championship. Now they barely squeaked by UConn, 1-2 against UConn. Then they got blanked at Florida, 42-0. Then they almost knocked off the South Carolina Gamecocks in Williams-Brice Stadium, only lost by 1. Then they got housed by Mississippi State, had an 11-point loss, or I'm sorry, 9-point loss to Missouri, and then kind of 17-point loss to Kentucky, 14-point loss at Ole Miss, 24-point loss in Knoxville to Tennessee. It was not a great year. Yeah, especially considering their two wins were combined by a total of 5 points. That's not great, but there's new life. All right, there's new life. Clark Lee's been building it the right way. You got to shout out to Clark Lee, former fullback from Vanderbilt. All right, let's make fullbacks great again. All right, I love that guy. All right, gotta have some just any fullback. So what, Seth Luttrell too? Shout out to the fullbacks getting it done on the coaching level. But you look at this team. Let's just hop into it because I think the schedule might be a little bit kinder this year. That makes sense. But yeah, Clark Lee just 2-10. I don't know if you're a Vanderbilt fan, if you're happy with Clark Lee. I would be because he's one of your own. And okay, 2-10. We kind of saw this coming. I mean, I played the under last year and it cashed for me, but you know, I feel like we were just talking Dave Clawson. Dave Clawson's first couple of years, he struggled to build this thing up right. You got to go through the fire. Well, last year I consider was the fire, and still might be this year. All right, but I think he's doing it the right way. Let's hop into it. On the offensive coordinator side, it's Joey Lynch. Joey Lynch, 128th in scoring offense from a season ago. That's not good considering there was only 130 teams in the FBS. So you were the third worst offense in America last year. 104th in rush offense, 104th in pass offense. Got a little consistency going there. Charting at 118 in total offense. So if you look at it there, 12th worst offense from a yardage standpoint, but from a scoring standpoint, 128. 7 starters back. And I saw, I believe they named Mike Wright the starting quarterback. I believe I read that over Ken Seals. So they got a little bit of depth here, considering that Seal, they both have starts. So kind of a good situation there. Running back wise, they bring in a transfer. They hit the portal to get Ramon Davis coming in from the Temple Owls, who might be a pretty good get for them in the portal. They also have Rocco Griffin in that backfield. Now they just have 1 of 3 back in the wide receiving core, and that is Will Sheppard. And they're, from what I'm seeing projected and rumored, I did a deep dive before this episode trying to find out. I think they're going to be starting 2 freshman wideouts in Jayden McGowan and Daveon Walker. Little concerning there. Tight end Bren Breschahan is back, and 3 of 5 offensive linemen are back. This is kind of a bit confusing here because they have three guys that have started games before is my point, but they are incredibly, incredibly young on the offensive line. There's freshmen and sophomores everywhere on that offensive line. They're led by Ben Cox. I don't know. It's going to be interesting to tell. Like when I see that youth at receiver and O-line, part of me goes, oh boy. But hey, got to learn somehow, right? Got to start somewhere. The new defensive coordinator is Nick Howe. Nick Howe is a Bronco Mendenhall protege. Now there's two sides to look at this. I am a team Bronco Mendenhall is an unbelievable coach. I'm here. I'm excited to see if he lands on as a head coach somewhere next year. But I will say this: last year, Virginia's defense was awful. And I couldn't believe it was a Bronco Mendenhall coach team because this was a team that couldn't tackle well last year. The effort to me at times was in question. Now other years, Bronco Mendenhall, you know, coach teams, I thought had a good defense or played in a chippy way. I did not see that on the field in Charlottesville a season ago. So concern. Yes. He's inheriting the 119th scoring defense, 107th against the rush, 114th against the pass, charting at 118 against in total defense. That's amazing that you know, you have 130 college football teams, and in total offense, Vanderbilt charts 118, and in total defense they chart 118. What are the odds on that? All right. Seven starters are back on defense. Three of four back on the D line. You like that, led by nose tackle Daveon Davis. Two of three in the linebacking core, led by Ethan Barr. Secondary is a bit of a question mark, but they do return two of four, led by strong safety senior Maxwell Worship. Kicker and punter are back. Well, they bring in a punter from the portal, but starters. I can tell you this, the defense should be better than last year. I think the schedule also helps them a little bit, but I don't know how talented this team is overall, but let's hop into it. But before I hop into it, I want to get us paid, people. I want to tell you guys out there, guys and gals, that the Vanderbilt Commodores 2022 season preview episode is brought to you by WinBet. Bet $100 at WinBet and get $100 free bet. Head over to sportsgamblingpodcast.com/winbet. That's sportsgamblingpodcast.com/WYNNBET to claim your free bet today. We're also brought to you by Odds Trader. Odds Trader is a place to compare odds from all the major sports books. You can also compare the different signup codes and promo codes from sports book to assure that you get yourself the best deal possible. The app also provides player stats, key game stats, injury reports, projected game day weather for bettors who make the most informed bets possible. It also has a bet tracker, so bettors can keep records of all your games and your betting activity, which is great for me because it organizes it. You get me in November and I got like action on 10 different sports. Sometimes you can get a little unorganized. This thing, boom, organizes it for you. Go to oddstrader.com/bluewire. Odds Trader, the number one site for all your game day bets. We're also brought to you by Run Your Pool. Yeah. I mean, Run Your Pool is the home of competition, bringing sports fans and their social circles together to compete, connect, and make every game matter more. And Run Your Pool offers every game you can think of under the sun. Let me just tell you that right there. Pick'em, Survivor, Fantasy Pools. It is a one-stop shop for sports gaming, and it's got customizable features that simply you won't get anywhere else. And get this, we've teamed up with Run Your Pool to host our official SGPN NFL Survivor contest. This thing is free to enter, folks. If you're listening to this, what are you doing, bozos? Get in there right now. Hop in to reserve your spot. $500 cash we're going to give away, plus a $250 gift card to the merch store to the winner. So what are you doing? Sign up. Sign up today over at play.runyourpool.com/SGPN. That's play.runyourpool.com/SGPN. All right, we are back talking Commodore football. I like to watch some Vandy. I like when Franklin and Mason had them bowling. It's great to see them being chippy. I think Clark Lee's on the right path. Let's hop into this. The portal. I think, unfortunately for Vanderbilt and Stanford and Northwestern, probably even Duke, although I don't believe I would be as educated on that situation as Northwestern and Stanford. Certainly not Baylor, though. But those schools that I mentioned right there, it's really hard for them in the portal. Stanford, unbelievably hard. I think Stanford's the hardest situation right now in college football, considering the portal, and they can't really get guys in, and everyone can leave as grad transfers once they get that. It's just a tough spot to be in. But Vanderbilt's in somewhat similar there. They brought in offensive tackle Jacob Brammer from the North Texas Mean Green. They brought in defensive lineman Miles Cecil from Cal Poly, John Madden's alma mater. They brought in punter Matt Hayball, penciled in to be a starter from the Florida Atlantic Owls. Brought in running back Cooper Lutz from the Syracuse Orangemen. Brought in linebacker Kane Patterson from Clemson. That seems to be a great get there. They brought in cornerback Jeremy Lucen from the UConn Huskies, where they won a national championship in 2020, according to the New York Times. And as I alluded to, Ramon Davis, the running back from Temple, that I think is going to be day one starter for the Commodores. So when you consider some of these guys will be penciled in as starters, you say they did a pretty good job. Not so fast though, because what they lost. It's pretty tough too. Running back James Ziegler, the third, he headed out to the Buffalo Bulls. Linebacker Michael Mincy went to Kennesaw State. Linebacker Austin Orgy went to the Campbell Camels, and Mike Minter. They lost offensive lineman Jason Brooks to Oklahoma State. That was a brutal loss, in my opinion. They lost defensive lineman Rashawn Wilkins to the Illinois Fighting Illini. They lost defensive lineman Jaquise Hunter to the portal. Running back Javion Marlowe, portal. Safety Deshaun Jerkins to Ole Miss. Brutal. This one was big here. Four-star offensive tackle Tyler Steen to Alabama, where he's projected to be a starter. I mean, that is so those three blows right there, Jerkins, Steen, and the kid to Oklahoma State, brutal. And then it gets a little worse. Defensive end Alex Williams, portal. Linebacker Braden DeVault Smith went to Samford in the SoCon. Safety Brendan Harris went to Wake Forest. They also lost wide receiver Amir Abdul-Rahman to Ball State. Cam Johnson at wide receiver to Arizona State. Defensive lineman Lorenzo Sergers to the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Cornerback Gabe Judy Lally to BYU. Defensive lineman Terion Sugik to Arkansas State. I mean, they got hit pretty bad. Obviously, quarterback Jeremy Musa to Florida A&M. Defensive lineman Marcus Bradley to the UMass Minutemen. I mean, they clearly lost the portal. Not as bad as Stanford, because Stanford can't bring in anybody, but they still got their ass whooped in the portal. And I think it's going to happen to these schools as college football continues to evolve until they can really put up. If these schools ever got their shit together and wanted to win at football, now would be the time. I know they're academics, but these schools got money. If they wanted to, the NIL could present some great possibilities. I know the academics will always be an issue. I don't know. Obviously football is not their calling card at these universities like Stanford, Northwestern and Vandy, but if they ever wanted to, it would be interesting. Flat out, they lost the portal. They lost the portal, and they're going to be extremely young again this year, I think, as a football team. So we're going to talk win total, what Las Vegas expects from the Commodores in 2022 and what we expect here on the College Football Experience. But first, I got to get us paid again. I want to tell you that the College Football Experience is brought to you by Sleeper. Sleeper is the fastest growing fantasy platform today with millions of players. You probably already have a fantasy league on there. I know I do. They just passed 4 million different users, and now you can win on Sleeper by playing their brand new over under game. First in any sport, you can choose two or more players you like and pick the over or under on their stat projection. And if you pick correctly, you can win anywhere from 2 times to 20 times your money. That's awesome. And with the NFL season right around the corner, Sleeper is the first sports contest built into the fantasy experience. So right now on your mobile phone, join our listener group on Sleeper at sleeper.com/SGP. That's sleeper.com/SGP, and Sleeper will automatically match your first deposit up to $100. We're also brought to you by Trade Coffee. Trade Coffee connects customers to the freshest and best tasting coffee they've ever made at home by partnering with the country's best craft roasters. And this thing is expert tasted. All right. They got a coffee team. Trade has a coffee team that taste tests thousands of different coffees. That's incredible. They keep over 450 different kinds live and ready to ship out to you every single day. There is no one perfect coffee, but there is a perfect coffee for you. And let Trade's human powered algorithm find it for you. Right now, Trade is offering new subscribers a total of $30 off your first order plus free shipping when you go to drinktrade.com/SGP. That's more than 40 cups of coffee for free, people. Get started today by taking their quiz at drinktrade.com/SGP and let Trade find you a coffee you'll love. We're also brought to you by Babbel. Yes, for most of us, learning a second language in high school or college wasn't exactly a high point of our academic careers. Certainly for myself. Now, thanks to Babbel, the language learning app that sold more than 10 million subscriptions. Wow. Maybe I need to get this. There's an, I'm telling you, this thing is fantastic. There's an easy way. There's an easy way to learn a new language, and whether you're traveling abroad or connecting in a deeper way with your family, or you just have free time. I can tell you this, my wife, she didn't grow up in America. So I'm trying to learn a language right now. I've been trying for the past like 6 months. So, This is a perfect thing for anyone in my situation or just in general. Like I said, traveling abroad, what are you doing? Babbel's 15-minute lessons make it the perfect way to learn a new language on the go. Other language learning apps, you know, use AI for their lesson plans, but Babbel lessons were created by over 100 different language experts. Their teaching method has been scientifically proven to be effective, people. And you could choose 14 different languages, including Spanish, French, Italian, German. Plus, Babbel's speech recognition technology helps you improve your like actual pronunciation and accent. You know, you don't want to say "gay quesadilla," something like that. You know what I mean? Right now, save up to 60% off your subscription when you go to babbel.com/SGP. That's babbel.com. That's babbel.com/SGP for up to 60% off. We're also brought to you by Elias. Yes, it's almost the start of NFL season. You know, I love this time of year, folks. And if you're into sports betting or fantasy, you need a competitive edge to win. That's why I highly recommend the Elias Game Pro, or I'm sorry, Game Plan app. It's the ultimate sports betting and fantasy companion for what NFL, MLB, NBA, whatever, you know. And it's the only sports app from the most trusted name in sports stats, you know, Elias Sports Bureau, the official statisticians of US pro sports leagues, like including the NFL. So their app lets you access team and player stats, head to head comparisons and Elias Insight, you know, it's just awesome. It's a one stop source for all of this stuff, player news, expert game analysis for betting, perfect for the preseason too. I mean, it's just a great thing. So take my advice, download the Elias Game Plan app today. NFL season is right around the corner, so don't wait. Find Elias Game Plan in the App Store or Google Play Store today. All right, we are back talking Commodore football. If you're watching on YouTube, you see this graphic here. Shout out to the SGPN graphics crew for supplying this. And remember, subscribe on YouTube, youtube.com/thecollegeexperience. The Vanderbilt Commodores win total sitting at 2.5 wins. 2.5 wins. Well, I can tell you this. On first thought, you would just say, no. I don't want to touch this thing. You know, there's no way they're getting the 3, even though they only won 2. They won 2 last year and they lost to an FCS. So they got 2 FBS wins last year. Is that possible to get them again this year? Let's dive into it because I'm curious myself as far as like what Clark Lee can do in year 2. And let me also tell you that the let me find that juice for you on this bet. So over 2.5 wins is +100, under is -120. So Vegas basically saying I see a 2-10 season again. Well, week 1 or week 0, just in a few days here, less than a week away. So what, 6 days from now, 5 days from now, they will be at the Ching Complex Center in Honolulu, Hawaii. And Hawaii had just about the craziest past 12 months with their football program. Todd Graham takes them to a bowl, 2 years ago. He exceeded my expectation, taking over for Nick Rolovich. And then this past year, in the middle of the season, it got ugly in Honolulu. Players, like the whole team, transferred. People were quitting. Todd Graham gets, you know, resigns. It got ugly. It got really ugly. But then the coaching search got crazy too, because they won the island won on June Jones. It didn't work out. Apparently, they only brought him in, and I know June Jones, went friend of the program for us, went public saying that they only brought me in to please the people. They don't really care. They were never seriously interested in me. And it just got ugly because Timmy Chang played quarterback for June Jones. So they went out and hired Timmy Chang, who was a wide receivers coach for Colorado State for about a month previously at Nevada last season. He followed Norvell to Colorado State. So Timmy Chang is from the island. He was a fantastic college football quarterback, and that's exciting. But from what I understand, from an administration standpoint, the athletic director, it has been a complete mess. So even though this is a far trip, and Hawaii has been a pretty good mid-major over the past 20 years. I mean, ask Alabama about the last time they played on the island. They took an L. Ask Michigan State about the last time they played on the island. They took an L. Same can be said for the Arizona Wildcats. Same can be said for, I believe, the Colorado Buffaloes. I mean, you can go on and on and on about the last. They normally have a decent, you know, advantage by being that far away. However, with all the production they lost, even though I do like the offensive coordinator hire for Hawaii, bringing in Eastern Washington's offense, but I just don't see a way that Hawaii wins this game with that much turnover on that roster. I think Hawaii's defense might be a complete mess. And I'm going to take Vanderbilt to be 1-0. Now, could I see this being a game? Certainly. It's a far fucking trip. These trips are at least it's week zero though. So you can get there long enough ahead of time, but still it is a very, very far trip. I think the Island, the actual fans want to see Timmy Chang succeed. So it might be a legit crowd for the Rainbow Warriors. I'm still taking Vandy. I think they're in a better spot. If they played this game next year on the Island, I would probably take Hawaii. However, I'm going to take Vandy to be 1-0. Then they come back home the very next week. They don't get a bye week. They host Elon. I don't know how many folks know about FCS football, but Elon, I have seen now they were just 6-5 from a season ago, but they are preseason top 25 in many FCS polls. So this is a dangerous game. You look at last season, Elon actually, with the exception of getting whooped by Villanova and James Madison and Appalachian State, their other losses, Wofford by 2, William and Mary by 3. And then, like I said, Villanova is like a blue blood in the FCS. James Madison is a blue blood in the FCS. They're now in the FBS. They're in the Sun Belt. And then App State's in the Sun Belt. So they knocked off Richmond, who's a good FCS team. They knocked off Campbell, who's a decent FCS team. They knocked off New Hampshire, who's not bad. Maine. I mean, these teams scored some wins last year. Rhode Island. Watch out. Watch out for this one. This is going to be a game. I'm going to take Vandy, but I would not be surprised if Vandy is down 24-21 with 5 minutes left and they got to figure out a way to get a win, or if Elon just flats out beat them. I wouldn't be surprised. You saw East Tennessee State do it last year. Watch out. But give me 2-0. Give me 2-0. And then they have a game against Wake Forest without Sam Hartman. Sam Hartman, poor Sam Hartman, and you know, wishing him the best. But you couldn't dream for a better scenario for Vanderbilt season if they, with the way Hawaii's in turmoil, like that game 2 years ago looked like there's no way Vanderbilt could win that on the Island. Now it's like, oh, that's a winnable game. Then an FCS and then Wake Forest without, you know, their best quarterback they've ever had. I mean, that's wild. I'm going to take Wake to get, I think Clawson will still get it done. I got Wake winning it. They're 2-1. And then a critical game. I actually think this is the Sling TV game of the season for Vanderbilt, because your over is going to reside on this thing. And so it is the Sling game of the season. So let me tell you folks, it's college football season, which means you need the unbeatable coverage of Sling TV starting at $35 a month. Sling has all the biggest games on the biggest channels like ESPN, ESPN2, ESPN3, SEC Network, ACC Network, Fox, and the Big Ten Network, all for the best price. You can stream it on any device, record up to 50 hours with included DVR space. You could pause or change your service at any time. Check out sling.com for special offers. Sling, the live TV you love for a price you'll love. Try us today. Oh man, I mean, this game is an interesting game. I mean, you look at Northern Illinois, they won the MAC a season ago. And actually DeKalb, in my opinion, where Northern Illinois resides, is I think the hardest home field environment in the MAC, because the fans show up, you know, but they get them before it gets cold. So the advantage there. But I do think Northern Illinois from a roster standpoint is more talented this year than last year. However, Northern Illinois was one of the luckier teams in all of America last year. But they did get hit recently with some terrible news when they found out that they're a guy that I think had 1,500 all-purpose yards or 1,400, Trayvon Rudolph, is out for the season. They still have Rocky Lombardi, who's related to Vince Lombardi. So Vanderbilt, this is kind of a 50-50 game to me, but I am taking Northern Illinois to get this game. Northern Illinois beat Georgia Tech at Georgia Tech a season ago. I know Georgia Tech and Vanderbilt pretty much on the same level. I'm taking Northern Illinois, but it wouldn't shock me. I think this line will be like Northern Illinois -3, which means it's very winnable. So they could hit your over in the month of September. I'm not projecting that because I think either Hawaii, Elon, or Northern Illinois, they'll lose one of those. So I got them 2-2. And now you got to find yourself getting a third win, and that means within the SEC. All right. I think they also, yeah. So here we go. They head to Tuscaloosa, Alabama to take on Alabama. Loss. They get a bye week, and then they are home to the Ole Miss Rebels. Ole Miss, transfer you. I mean, they actually played Ole Miss pretty decently last year, so maybe Clark Lee will have someone's bag. I got Ole Miss winning that, though. So that puts them there at 2-4. Then they're at Georgia, 2-5. Then they're at Missouri. This is a sneaky one here. Could they get the Missouri Tigers? I'm going to say this is another, I mean, I would favor Missouri by like 6-7. But if they could get one, I think it would be this one. And I think if they don't get this one, you can kiss the over goodbye because they get a bye week. Then they're home to South Carolina. I don't see them being able to win that. Then they're at Kentucky. I don't see them being able to win that. Then they're home to Florida. No, I think Florida still gets it done. And then home to Tennessee. I don't think that's going to happen this year. As much as I want to take the over, I think I have to take the under. Yes, could they beat Northern Illinois? Yes, could they knock off Missouri or pull a random upset against, you know, Ole Miss or Florida at home? Highly unlikely, but it wouldn't shock me because I don't think those teams will be as good as, well, Florida will be, I think, similar to what last year was, but I think Ole Miss might be a little bit down. I'm going to ride the under in the Commodores. But it's tempting because they could beat Northern Illinois. They could cash that thing by September 17th. However, I'm going to take the under. Give me the under on the Commodores. I'm rooting for you, though, Clark Lee. And I do think be patient here. Be patient. It's on the right track. Let them build it. If you build it, wins will come. All right. Subscribe to the College Football Experience, people. And remember, subscribe to the College Basketball Experience and the College Baseball Experience, wherever you listen to podcasts at. Remember also to subscribe. We're all together as one on YouTube, youtube.com/thecollegeexperience. Subscribe, tell a friend, check out the Sports Gambling Podcast. They're already doing, they already did 32 episodes on every single NFL team. Tennessee Titans fans, what are you doing? Go out and check that out. Hey, but hold on. Tennessee Titans fans, what are you guys doing trying to get a dome? That's ridiculous. You're in Tennessee. Look at Neyland. Look at the Liberty Bowl. Those stadiums are great. You do not need a dome to play football if you're the Tennessee Titans. All right, stop it. I don't care about hosting a Super Bowl. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Don't do it. Subscribe to the Sports Gambling Podcast, though. Go listen to their episodes. Whether whoever your NFL team is, they got you covered on the win totals. Check out the NFL Gambling Podcast. Check out the MLB Gambling Podcast. MLB season rolling along. What else? What else do we got? I mean, The whole feed is just full of what else does Tennessee love? All right, NASCAR Gambling Podcast, check it out. Formula One Gambling Podcast, check it out. The World Cup's around the corner. Check out the Soccer Gambling Podcast, the MLS Gambling Podcast. Get the SGPN app in the App Store, and it's free to download. You'll get access to all of our content, articles, podcasts. You'll have access to it all. Check it out. And one of my favorite things, I grew up in a household full of people. So I miss the connection. I'm a married guy. I got a cat and a dog. I'm at home. I'm watching the games and my wife's not into sports. So she's doing her own thing. And I just, oh, did you see that catch? Oh, what a slam dunk. What a home run, whatever it is. I'm sitting there saying, who's watching this? But one of the best things about the internet is that we have the Discord channel, sportsgamblingpodcast.com/discord. No matter what you like, it could be monster truck madness. I'm telling you, in that Discord, there's going to be a home for you. Cause I'm in there talking college football, college baseball, college basketball, pro, whatever. We're in there chatting away, having fun. Check it out. sportsgamblingpodcast.com/discord, whether you're betting on games or not. And if you're betting on games, you really should get in there, cause we have some nice intel that drops in there, from time to time. Check it out, folks. All right. Also give us a follow on Twitter at TCE on SGPN. And I'm on Twitter at TheColbyD. Give me a follow as well. And remember, if you can get over to iTunes and give us a 5-star review, we'd certainly appreciate it. So hop on over there, give us a 5-star review. It takes like a minute out of your day. And if you do that, take a screenshot. Find me on Twitter at TheColbyD or the College Football Experience at TCE on SGPN. Show us that. And we're going to enter you in a David Stern like raffle where you're guaranteed to win at some point. A gift card to the SGPN merch store. Let's do it. All right, folks, this is the College Football Experience, Vanderbilt Commodore style. You better start thinking about yours, and we out of here.
Sometimes it may be good, sometimes it may be shit.
Because when you're in East Carolina, you go for it every time. Or you don't coach in East Carolina, you don't come to East Carolina, you don't play at East Carolina with a weak heart. Write it.
The Redskins want a new stadium. The owner, Jack Kent, and he wants an indoor, I heard an indoor stadium. The Redskins cannot play indoors. I mean, how can you see fun? How can this guy...
I smoke and I drink and I don't have stress and I'm healthy.
Well, I don't get they bring the head cold.
Get my limousine right on 85. Get my Learjet. Woo! And take off to New Orleans.
Coaching, our coaching did a horrible job. The players did a horrible job. We got our ass kicked in the second half.
They're begging us. Please have a party. Beat us, drink. Get us.